Hey guys, it's Cabover Gary back here. Welcome back to the channel. Please don't forget to subscribe to the channel, like the video if you like it. But it's January 15th in Texas of 2021, and there's 8 inches of snow outside and freaking cold. So I decided that I was going to convert the service cart that I have for a different purpose. Let me show you what I got here. So I got this old Harbor Freight cart, and what I've been using it for is for my reloading supply. So I built this out of MDF and covered it, and I used to keep it in my closet and just roll it around. Well, I don't really have room. I moved into a new house. I don't really have room to keep it there. So I'm going to convert it over to a polishing cart so I can roll it out in the driveway and have all my polishing stuff in one spot. So one of the things is that it's got these small little wheels on it, and I just don't think that they're going to work too good rolling around outside. So these are just Harbor Freight, but they're 8-inch wheels. I'm going to remove those, put these on. I got two that are fixed and two that are swivel. I'm going to add some steel to the bottom side. This is just 16 gauge. Just something I could get today, but for the weight that I'm going to carry in this cart, it should be plenty. So let me get the cart cleared out and I'll show you where we're at. Okay, so first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to cut these all flush. Oops. These all flush. So this is a flat surface. These wheels stick up quite a bit higher already, so I don't want to gain too much room. So the only reason why I wanted to add the steel is really for this bolt here, because it's going to be pressing on the inside. So, being tied together between the two, I think will add some rigidity. Then also, since this is going to be cut flush here, this is going to be a hole, so I'll be able to bolt that steel to this, and I think that'll help a little bit as well. But, yeah. I think I'm going to do this with hand tools, because I don't really want to get the power tools out. It's cold, and I don't want to deal with having to clean up and stuff after I'm done, and I think this will cut just as fast with a hacksaw. So, let me get that going. using a speed square, just lined it up, drew a line. Same thing on this side. I don't know if this is, this might be too thick to get a sheet metal up. Cutters for, let's see. That's 16 gauge. Yeah. Okay, I'm just gonna use this as a template and score this line until it comes loose. I'm going to take a file and knock down the edges a little bit. All right. these front wheels on, finish this project up. My good drill bits I left out of my truck. I've been using them down there. So I got kind of left as the stragglers. This is just perfect. You can lift just about anything. Alright, I'm going to square this up, tighten it down, move on to the next. It looks like, unfortunately, this one is too close to this post. So what I'm going to do is later on, I don't feel like digging it out right now, but I'll get my rib nut gun out and put a rib nut in it. That will work good there. Last one for the off-road cart. All right. So I'm going to mount this one a little farther in so I don't do that same. I think I need to mount it the same way, or these being the swivel ones are going to work weird. So I just put two rib nuts in. Yeah, that's gonna work out pretty good. You can see the wheel size difference. It rolls over stuff really well. Pretty happy with that. Well guys, thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed this episode, and I hope you guys subscribe to the channel and like the video, and I'll be with you with some more. Thanks.